What's up, party people? Greetings and salutations from the Festival of Arts at Epcot. My name is Ichabod Bones, a.k.a. the Incognito Mouse. But you can call me Icky. If you're new to my channel, I'd like to welcome you here. I am a full-time cast member here at Walt Disney World, sharing with you my journeys and adventures from a cast member point of view. And about this time of day in the mid-afternoon, I just got off work. I worked a full shift here at Walt Disney World, making magic for the guests. Decided on my way home after I was off to pop in here at Epcot. I love just walking around Epcot. If you know me, you know I love this fountain. I love fountains in general, but this is beautiful. But I haven't been here since the Festival of the Arts. I'm not one to cover festivals like your typical YouTubers do. But I thought that I would pop in here just to look around, maybe check a few of the booths. It seems like, from what I've heard, that it's the same food and stuff that was here from before. But there's a specific topic that I wanted to talk about. I'm not showing myself in the camera because I wasn't planning on stopping and doing this today. It was completely impulsive. It was last minute, like, you know what? I'm going to go to Epcot. And I did not bring my signature hat or sunglasses to keep myself incognito. And I don't want y'all to know who I be. So we're just going to keep the camera facing out. And I think it works better that way anyway. Just a quick view here. You can see how crowded it is. So, story I want to tell you today, if you saw the title of the video, this is something that happened over a year ago. I've been sitting on this situation, this story, if you will, for a long time because it didn't seem particularly interesting or relevant, you know, at the time. But considering recent goings on this YouTube channel, especially the video that I made about why I don't watch the big time Disney YouTubers anymore, this kind of, you know, dovetails right in, because this is kind of the I don't want to say the straw that broke the camel's back, maybe the ball that started rolling the whole thought process in motion. This is the first thing that happened with a big YouTuber that kind of got a bad taste in my mouth, if you know what I mean, for you know, just a general disinterest in larger YouTubers. Like, they're disconnected, they don't care. And when I say that, I mean some of them, not all of them. There are some really big YouTubers that are really into their community. Someone mentioned Lou Mangiello the other day. Lou Mangiello is really cool. He really loves interacting with his community, and that's kind of what I would like us to become. But anyway, so I have this story that I want to share with you guys, but I was very hesitant to share it for a couple different reasons. And we'll get to the story. If you aren't patient enough to wait to hear my ramble, then you can go watch some other video. I really don't care. This is my channel. I'm going to do what I want to do. If you don't like it, leave. Just kidding. Don't leave. But yes, I am serious. When I first decided to make the move here, I had taken a vacation here, decided that I wanted to do this, and I was tired of scraping ice and snow off my bus. I was a bus driver up in the nasty Northeast. Nasty because of the nasty weather. I have to always put in that disclaimer. Nasty weather. So I was up there, and I was down here on vacation. I'm like, why am I not driving a bus for Disney? I put in my mind that I was going to do it, and then here we are. So, as my wife and I were preparing to make the move, saving money and looking for a place to live and downsizing and all that, I started immersing myself in YouTubers, Disney YouTubers. Any Disney YouTuber I could find, I subscribed, I listened, I got involved in the community, I commented, I chatted, and a lot of them are very, very kind. Most of them, you know, I'm not here to say anything bad about anybody. Most of them were very, very, and still are very, very, very friendly. But I had one particular situation with this one YouTuber who will remain nameless, because I'm not here to throw shade on anybody. I'm not here to talk bad about anybody. What this person did was not very nice, but you know what? We all have a bad day, and I'm guessing if this person were shown this incident and could go back and probably would say, hey, yeah, looking back, that was probably stupid of me. I wish I wouldn't have done that. So I'm not holding it against this person, and I'm not going to tell you who the person is because I'm not here to start drama. I'm not here to start shade. I don't want to start some stupid Dizzney rap battle beef like Eminem and Machine Gun Kelly or something stupid like that. I'm not here to look for drama to get views. I'm just sharing with you a fun story, sharing with you my journeys and adventures from a cast member point of view, and I thought you may want to hear the story. So about a year, maybe a year and a half ago, I don't know, my channel was much smaller. It's not really big now, but it was much smaller, and I was watching several, like I said, big YouTubers, and there's one particular YouTube channel that's quite large. If you are at all into the YouTube Disney community, and I mentioned the name of this channel, you would probably instantly know who it was. So I won't do that, because I don't want to throw any shade at anybody. But anyway, popcorn. But anyway, I would regularly watch the videos of this channel. I didn't comment that much, but you know, somewhat. I would watch and comment, I would subscribe, all that kind of stuff. And I began noticing that the titles of the videos became increasingly more and more clickbaity, if you will. The titles of the videos became more and more clickbaity. I'm putting this here because this may be a good thumbnail. The one at the beginning with Festival of the Arts was really good too. Their videos became clickbaity. I don't like clickbaity videos. So before we go any further, let me stop and define my interpretation of the word clickbait and what clickbaity means. And I want you to leave the comments below and tell me if you agree with that definition. If you don't, share with me what you think clickbait is, because this is important moving forward. Because if I have my definition or my understanding wrong, then none of this makes any sense. Okay? So to me, when I think of a clickbait title, I think of a video that's been given a title, and the title of the video is intentionally outrageous, more so than the actual video, or has nothing to do with the video at all, or is intentionally misleading, is intentionally sensational to the point of being misleading, so that you're like, oh my gosh, you click on it and it's like, that's not what this video is about. So it's intentionally overstating what's in the video to be intentionally misleading, right? So for example, let's just say there was a video that was titled, I fell off a 50-story building and lived. You'd be like, oh my gosh, how did that happen? Was there some kind of miracle? Did your bones break and you went through years of rehab? Was there some kind of miracle, something that stopped your fall? What happened? So you see a video, I'm just using an example. You see a video that says, I fell off a 50-story building and I survived. So you're like, you click the video. And then the video turns out being a video of somebody who went base jumping off a 50-story video, off a 50-story building. Or they went bungee jumping off a bridge that was 50 stories high. Or they took their GoPro and strapped it to a tennis ball and dropped, you know, something like that. So that you're like, yeah, you didn't really fall off a 50-story building. You base jumped. That's different. You had a wingsuit on. You had a parachute on. You didn't fall. You jumped. You intentionally, when you say, I fell off a 50-story building and lived, it makes it sound like it was accidental or malicious and you sustained significant injuries, but yet survived. So that's my definition of clickbait. That would be clickbait because it's not true. It's intentionally over-sensational to get people to watch the video, and then the actual content is not as sensational as the title would imply. Okay? So leave me a comment what you think about that. Pause the video, leave your comment. Can that be agreed upon as a common definition of what clickbait is? Okay. So now let's move along with the story. This big YouTuber that I had been watching regularly, subscribed, watch all the time, would put out videos, you know, regularly, a couple a week, I don't remember, would put out big videos regularly, and I started to notice that the videos were getting more and more clickbaity, increasingly and increasingly, like, the title would say something, and I'm like, yeah, that's not really what happened. And it was a little frustrating to me because I don't like being misled. I don't like clickbait. I don't like being lied to, whatever. But I was just like, okay, whatever. You know, I like this YouTuber. I'm going to keep watching. And then there was this one day where there was a video and the title just was so over the top. I was like, are you kidding me? I don't remember exactly what the video title was, but I'm going to kind of paraphrase and give a theoretical of, I'm trying to show you how egregious the misdirection was. I'm not saying that this is what the title of the video was. I'm not saying that this is the exact content of the video, but it was something like this. You see what I'm saying? I'm just trying to give you an example of how far off base what the title said to what actually happened. So let's just say, for example, the title of the video was, I almost died today in Hollywood Studios. So you're like, holy cow, you almost died. I mean, what happened? Did you fall off of, did something hit you? Did you get run over by an ECV? Did you fall off of the Star Wars ride and the trackless ride ran you? What happened? How did you almost die? So, you know, you're like, oh my gosh, this is extreme. I want to find out how you almost died. So I clicked on the video because I want to see how this person almost died at Hollywood Studios. So as I'm watching, this video is no different than any other video. You know, it's kind of like a daily vlog. Get up, go to work, whatever. Kind of like I'm doing right now. Go to a park after work, whatever. I don't remember exactly what it was, but somehow the person ended up at Hollywood Studios. And so the person was doing a particular scene where they had the camera facing them and had the camera far away, so it was like a wide shot. So you could see them in the middle of the screen and a whole bunch of screen on either side. You know what I'm saying? Like a wide shot. And there was a trash can kind of behind the person and off to the side. And the point of the video was that this YouTuber had a friend who was in town. And this YouTuber had not seen this particular friend, or it was a family member, maybe, I don't know. I think it was a friend. So this YouTuber had not seen their friend in a long, long time. And this person's friend had came into town unexpectedly and was going to surprise them. So the friend, while this YouTuber was doing a video shot of themselves, this friend popped out from behind the garbage can and surprised the YouTuber. So what the title of this video should have been, I think I'm gonna go back here and look at these waterfalls back here in Canada, because I don't get back here very often. Let me see if I can get back there and find my way to those waterfalls. What the title of the video should have been was, my long lost friend, or my friend who I haven't seen in a long time, came to visit me and I was super excited. That should have been the title of the video. My friend who I haven't seen in a long time came to visit me and I was super excited. That should have been the title of the video, but that is not very interesting. Who cares? Who wants to see a video of your friend who came to see you, who you haven't seen in a long time and you're super excited about? That doesn't generate clicks. People don't want to watch that. So what the person decided to do was put a post and say, I almost died at Hollywood Studios. The point being, when my friend jumped out and said surprise, I was so happy, I was so overcome with emotions that I almost died, figuratively. So, I mean, when I saw that, I was like, really? And I was just kind of frustrated. There were already several videos that were getting more and more clickbaity. And when I saw that, I was like, ooh, look, there's another UK phone back here. Nice. So when I saw that video, I was like, you know, I'm getting really tired of this. So I left a comment on the video. And I said something like, I don't remember exactly what I said, but I said something like, yo, I really enjoy your videos, but your videos are getting a little bit clickbaity, don't you think? Or something like that. I wasn't caring about it. I wasn't rude about it, but I was just like, yo, what's going on with your videos? They're getting kind of clickbaity. And I thought that would be the end of it. But to my surprise, this YouTuber responded, which is really the only reason why I even stuck around and watched their videos anyway. I got a comment back. I got a response back from this YouTuber. And it was rather rude. I don't remember exactly what they said, but it was something to the effect of, oh, this is what all YouTubers do. This is how we get our views. When you become a big YouTuber, you'll understand, or something like that. I don't remember exactly what the comment was, but it was something like that. You know, kind of like dismissing it, like, oh, be quiet. You don't know what you're talking about. You're a little YouTuber. I'm a big YouTuber. This is what big YouTubers do. And I was like, okay, well, I watch a lot of big YouTubers, and I've never seen them, you know, like, over-exaggerate their video thumbnails or anything like that. I don't see big YouTubers doing clickbait. I don't get back here. I haven't been back here for a long time. This is so cool. Hopefully you can hear me. So I actually thought it was kind of cool. I was like, wow, a big YouTuber like that responding to a little guy like me. I respect that. That's pretty cool. And this was a big channel at the time. So I was like, all right, I'll let it go. I'll keep watching, see what happens, whatever. Very next video that came out was the same type of material that this channel would always put out. Very, you know, Dizzney, go out to the parks, whatever. Same type stuff. But it had a more regular title, like going out to eat at Garden Grill, or I don't know what it was, I have no idea, but I remember it was just like, I remember thinking, all right, we're back to regular titles now, that's cool. So about a minute or so into the video, after the intro and all the opening chit chat, whatever, the people in the video were getting ready to go leave the house and go out to the parks or to go do whatever they were gonna do. And they were like, all right, let's go eat at the Garden Grill. For example, let's just say, hypothetically, if the title of the video was, we're going to go eat at the Garden Grill, and they said, all right, now we're going to go eat at the Garden Grill. We wouldn't want to put any, you know, clickbaity title and scare people away. And, you know, very, very rude and very sarcastic. And I paused the video. And I was like, are you, what just happened? Are you kidding me? And I was in, I rewound it back and I listened again. We're gonna go to the Garden Grill. We wouldn't want to put anything clickbaity and, you know, upset our viewers or whatever. Whatever they, I don't remember what exactly words were used, but I was like, there's no way. There's no way this clown just threw shade at me on video. Like, is it 100% sure? No, it's not 100% sure, but I'd say it's about 95% sure, don't you think? They had just put out a video. I had just commented on it, yo, your video titles are a little clickbaity, and then got a rude response back. That's just what big YouTubers do. And then the very next video, oh, we wouldn't want it to be clickbaity and upset people. So I was like, all right, I don't need to watch your videos. So I unsubscribed. I stopped the video, went to the homepage of that channel, unsubscribed, closed it out, and went about my day. And for the next, whatever, week or two, whenever that person's videos would come up in my recommended, I would click the three dots, do not recommend this channel. Not interested. So, you know, after about a week or two, I guess, I don't remember, they just stopped showing up. This channel stopped showing up in my recommended. And I was like, that's pretty petty. I watch a YouTube channel called Diz Unplugged. You know who the Diz Unplugged is? With Pete Warner. I've talked about that channel before. Pretty big channel. They do like round table discussion chats and all kinds of stuff. Pete, I love Pete. I could just sit and listen to Pete talk all day. His voice, it's just something about it. And the other people, I love Denny and I love Rhino and everybody. I don't want to go through and name everybody, but you know, if you know the Diz Unplugged, I love that show. And in an episode recently, Pete was talking about if you're going to go after another YouTube channel, you don't punch down. Meaning, if you're a big channel, you don't go and attack and make fun of a smaller channel. You don't punch down. You punch up. It's just tacky and rude and not in good taste to punch down. And that's kind of what made me, that's kind of what reminded me about this situation. I was like, oh yeah, that guy, that YouTube channel punched down. They totally punched down. This right here is the best food, I think, in the entire festival. This French Gouda baguette. I'm not going to walk in front of them because they're taking a picture, but I love this. But I was like, that's why I'm making this video. I'm like, they totally punched down. Like, why would you single out and be snarky like that? And I was like, that's kind of the thing with bigger, with this YouTube channel. Not all YouTube channels. There are a lot of big YouTube channels that are very friendly. I watched Resort TV One for a while, and I've never saw them be rude. You know, people have their concerns and their complaints about Resort TV One, but I thought they were cool. I never had a problem with them. And but anyway, I thought that was just a cool little story that I wanted to share with you guys. Leave your comments below. Leave your thoughts below. There's no need to try to guess. If you try to guess who it was, I'm not going to allow the comment. I have all the comments set to where they have to be approved before they go up. I don't want them to try to guess. It doesn't matter. It's done. It's gone. It's gone. It was over a year ago. There's no way you could go back and try to find the video because it's like over a year ago, and I'm sure this channel has put out 100, if not 200-300 videos since then. So there's no way. And I don't want you to, and it doesn't matter. It was just a matter of, you know, wow, these people did that. Okay, this. And I was just like, okay, that just happened. I'm done with that channel. So I hope I don't ever become that way. I love interacting with you guys. It is so crowded here. Holy cow. Look how crowded it is. All right, so actually, thanks for watching. I'm going to head back around this way because in my next video, tune back in tomorrow. Tomorrow's video, I'm going to go over to the Seas Pavilion. And I'm just, holy cow, look at that tower of drinks right there. I'm going to go over to the Seas Pavilion. I'm going to go inside right now and just do a completely silent, no talk, relaxing stroll through the Seas Pavilion. I haven't gone in there very many times, and when I do, it's usually rushed. So I'm going to try to go through and just look at all the fish, all the sea life, the manatees, and see, go up to the top levels and see everything that there is to see that I've never seen before. So come back tomorrow and watch that video. There will be no talking. Zero talking. I won't even do an intro. My intro will just be words on the screen. So if you just want to sit back and watch and enjoy the sounds with out here and me yap, then that's the video to do it on. So please leave your comments. Tell me what you think about this video. And remember, wasio na hofu, Swahili, for they who have no fear. Hurry back.